In the previous video of the series, we discussed the budding field of Canadian military scholarship which arose in the years following the First World War. We saw how, following the publication of a few less than thorough attempts at a World War I history, the rise of historians such as Archer Duguid and Charles Stacey, who dedicated themselves to producing detailed and official accounts of Canada's contribution to the war. In this video, we will discuss the World War II and post-war period from 1945 to 1970 and the further development of this new historical profession. World War II, which in reality was a continuation of the tensions established in World War I, served as an even more violent and bloody sequel to its predecessor. Greater technology allowed for more widespread and destructive warfare, which resulted in a death toll the likes of which the world had never seen, around 75 million in total, many of whom were innocent civilians and victims of Nazi genocide. Needless to say, following the end of the war, the general public was not eager to revisit the tragedies which had unfolded just years prior. However, like the period following the First World War, we see a number of historians begin to investigate the decade's events and write about them in detail. During this time, we see the rise of a few new and fairly unique historical perspectives, the first of which were historians such as May Croft Pearson and W.A. Deakin, who detailed the effect the war had on the psyches of the young men involved. Pearson paid special attention to this in her work, which advocated for a greater understanding of the unimaginable horrors these young soldiers had been subjected to. We also see the emergence of on-the-ground reporting, like was done by Ross Munro, who traveled alongside the Allied fighting forces, giving a first-hand perspective of the realities of war. In the works of such journalists as Lionel Shapiro, Richard Malone, and Raymond Hickey, we see the publication of more Canadian-centered perspectives on the war and coverage of the various contributions our troops were making on the battlefield. This was undoubtedly a result of Canada gaining more international relevance and cultural independence from Britain. However, the most important historian of this era was Charles Stacey, who we spoke about briefly in the previous video. Stacey, who was educated at an American university and later went on to teach at Princeton, was part of the first generation of historians who were formally trained in the scholarly field of military history. He published some important pieces during the interwar period, but it wasn't until the Second World War and the years following that he rose to the prominence he enjoys today. During World War II, Stacey was appointed as the historical officer of the Canadian military at the Allied military headquarters in London, where he had access to the information he would later convey in his detailed histories, which would be released in the decades following the war. Stacey was guided by the need to share the inspiring story of Canadian achievements throughout the war, and was widely known for showing history as an official history and not a court history, which means without any influence from politics. Stacey, along with a number of his contemporaries such as Gerald Graham, George Stanley, and Richard A. Preston, published a number of works on the Second World War which gained worldwide praise and recognition, although they were sometimes criticized for their interpretations of a few international primary source documents. Throughout the decades following the Second World War, Stacey refused to let the Canadian military effort be forgotten and continued to publish works on the subject, such as his 1970 study on Canadian wartime government policy. Stacey recognized that the Canadian people were not very nationalistic and lacked the pride in their soldiers that other countries had. Thus, in his work, he wished to instill a sense of pride in the hearts of Canadians, inviting them to explore the heroic and important contributions made by people just like them only decades before. Overall, this period from 1945 until 1970 was integral to the maturation of the Canadian military historical profession. While there was a budding field of military scholarship prior to the events of World War II, it was far less internationally regarded and suffered from a lack of diverse perspectives such as the ones listed in this video. Thus, this period, which also saw the rise of Canada as a prominent international power, saw a number of different points of view and schools of thought emerge. This helped the profession of military history transition from a stage of adolescence into the mature field of study we recognize it as today.